What's the difference between a high pressure and a low pressure spray foam system? Let's talk about it. Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to be discussing the differences between a low pressure and a high pressure spray foam system. Before we get into that, please go below and hit that like button for us. So the first thing we're going to look at when comparing a low pressure and a high pressure spray foam system is cost. Now, generically speaking, a low pressure system will cost less than a high pressure system. When you think about it, a low pressure system, you're getting some type of pack or kit, some type of small container that you can use for your project. Whereas a high pressure system, now you're looking at a truck and trailer type of setup where you're bringing in a contractor to come in. Now, keep in mind, the cost will be relative to the size of your project. If you are looking to do a huge pole barn, and if you want to do that with a low pressure system with froth packs, for example, the amount of froth packs you'll have to purchase to effectively insulate that entire area will outdrive the upfront cost of just having a professional contractor bringing in a high pressure system. So keep that in mind with cost, the size of your project will be relative. Next, we're going to be talking about the capability range of the two different systems. So a low pressure system, again, we're talking about canned foams up to froth packs, different things like that, kits that you can purchase yourself as a homeowner, or even something that a contractor might bring out to use for a small area. And that's the thing, a low pressure system is really designed to use for a small project. We're talking the rim joist in the basement. Maybe you're closing off a window or a door frame, something like that. You just need to go around the house and air seal. Those type of projects and measures are perfect for a low pressure system. Canned foams up to froth packs, they're really designed for those type of things and they handle them very well. Whereas a high pressure system, that range is much, much wider. You can use a high pressure system for any of those smaller projects, rim joist, air sealing measures, that sort of thing. But you can also do that for a large project, the entire attic area. If you're remodeling a house and need to insulate all the walls, or a large pole barn or a commercial building. So again, a high pressure system is really designed to run the gamut and you be used on any type of project. Whereas a froth pack, it's kind of limited, but that's by design. It's really made and intended for smaller projects. So keep that in mind. And when you're trying to determine which way you should go, high pressure or low pressure, just look at your project. So the last thing we want to talk about in this is the availability of the two different systems. Now keep in mind, a low pressure system can be available to you from almost any big box hardware store. You can go and purchase canned foam and usually froth packs at most of these locations. This makes it a really good DIY option for you if you're the type of person that really is determined to do your projects yourself for your home. Whereas a high pressure system, you really have to get a professional contractor involved where they will bring out a truck and trailer system that encompasses everything. So keep that in mind. If you are bound and determined to do your project yourself and it is a relatively small area, there's a lot of availability and options for you for a low pressure system. Just some things to keep in mind when you're trying to decide which way to go. If you want to learn more about high and low pressure spray foam systems, please check out the link in the description below. Don't forget, subscribe to our channel and ring that bell to see all of our notifications.